الصلاة والسلام يزاد لا حسد إلا في اثنتين. No حسد, no envy except in two things. That means no حسد is valid. حسد is a sin, is a major sin. But it's only permissible, it's good in two things. Al-hasad, which is always sinful at all levels, even in these two things, what is meant by al-hasad is when the person has in his heart the wish that when he sees someone has a favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon him, he would wish that that person loses it. That he would have what that person has and he loses it. So this is hasad, this is evil. And that includes what's mentioned in the hadith and anything. It's haram for a person to have in his heart that he wish evil for his brother, that he wish that he would lose whatever money he has, whatever house he has, and he would have this instead of him. And this is an evil action, as we know, mentioned in the Quran. So this is a major sin. If a person feels something like that, al-'adhu billah, he should push it away from his heart immediately. And to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that individual, that Allah bless whatever he has. Allahumma barik lahu. And we have been commanded by the Sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, which is in the subject of al-ayn, the evil eye, which is haqq. Al-aynu haqq. The eye is haqq, is true, as the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and that's a huge subject. So how to cure this if a person follow the commands of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام? Someone, even you say, don't praise yourself. Don't say, I'm not envying. It's not about envy. If you see something, every time you see something you like, a brother wearing something nice, his son, his house, his car, materialistic matters, his knowledge, his Quran, his sound of the Quran. MashaAllah, leads a young person, leads the people in Taraweeh, and his sound of the Quran is nice. What should you do? You should say, Allahumma barik lahu bi qira'ati, or whatever. Oh Allah, bless whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him. Don't praise yourself by saying, I don't have any evil feeling inside. Just make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Prophet commanded us. But what is mentioned in the hadith here is the hasad, which is in the meaning of al-ghibta, that a person would wish that he would have what that other person has without that other person losing it. Right? So the first one is evil, for the person to lose. But the second one, for the materialistic things, can you see someone driving a nice car? Can you say, I wish, or you don't have to say, in your heart, that you would wish to have the like of this car? No, you shouldn't. Because it's only valid in two cases, and that's it. If you get this into your heart, which is a normal thing, right? There's nothing wrong with having it, push it away. You push away that from your heart by thinking, that's arzak is by Allah. You know, this is not the thing that I need to be concerned about like this. Because the Prophet ﷺ, he said, لَا حَسَدَ إِلَّا فِي اثْنَتَيْنِ. The permissible one, which is that you would wish to have without the other person losing it, it's only in two cases. The first one, رجل, a man, أَتَاهُ اللَّهُ هَذَا الْكِتَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him this book, meaning the Qur'an. He gave him the Qur'an. What is the meaning of giving him the Qur'an? He's from the people of the Qur'an. Reciting, memorizing, reflecting, acting, and so on. The knowledge of the Qur'an with all what that means. But then, فَقَامَ بِهِ أَنَا اللَّيْلِ وَأَنَا النَّهَارِ. قَامَ بِهِ. On al-qiyam, like the Salatul Qiyam, he prays with the Qur'an, the hours, and that is the time, hours of the night and hours of the day. And the hours of the day, reciting it, and that's why al-qiyam is not necessarily just standing in the salah, but reciting the Qur'an, and also as the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and as the way of the early generations of Islam, they would stand up in the salah during the night with the Qur'an, and they would implement it in the morning. And of course, implementing it during the night. But the night is مَظِنَّةِ الْعِبَادَةِ. Always the night is the ibadah time. And then the day people go to work, the Sahaba radiallahu anhu were not staying all day reading Quran and that's it. They will go out and seek provisions from Allah. So you go to your work, you go to your shop, you go whatever there is, you're implementing what you recited the day before, the Quran. So you're living the Quran. So this is, if you see someone like this, you would wish to have the same without him losing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon him. And the second case, وَرَجُلْ أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا. And a man, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him money. And al-mal is anything that has value. So it doesn't have to be cash money, but he has properties, money, whatever there is. He's wealthy. Then فَتَصَدَّقَ بِهِ أَنَاءَ اللَّيْلِ وَأَنَاءَ النَّهَارِ. فَتَصَدَّقَ بِهِ. So he gives charity in the hours of the night and in the hours of the day. So you want to be like that man for what reason? so that you have a luxurious life? No, because of the sadaqah, because he's giving sadaqah. If someone is having lots of wealth and he doesn't give sadaqah, never wish to be like that person. This is a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that wealth will be a source of regret for him. So you only wish in your heart if he's someone generous, giving for the sake of Allah. This is a great reward. The ayat in the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. And the only thing that comes into that level of the virtue and the righteousness of the person is always the wealth. So there is always either a person has knowledge or has wealth. If he has wealth, he has to act upon it with knowledge, right? And he would give for the sake of Allah according to the knowledge, or he has the people of knowledge and so on. And also, there's another benefit in the hadith. If you have money, don't give only sadaqah during the day or only during the night. Try to give sadaqah during the day, sometimes sadaqah during the night. So that ana al-layli wa al-nahar. So it's a ibadah by itself that a person would do this. Because of the time, we should stop here, inshallah ta'ala, even though the next hadith is in the same subject or explains the previous one, but we'll do that, inshallah ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of the Quran and to give those things. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.